thank you so kindly for being here. Who am I speaking to?
Hey, how you doing? My name's Mike. I'm from Columbus, Ohio.
Talk to me, Mike.
There's a lot of topics in politics that are being censored by everybody. Did you know that?
Yes, I did know that.
Any subjects about race that are negative, they censor. Have you ever noticed this?
Well, I don't talk a lot about race. I talk about race when it, you know, as a subject when it matters, but I don't do what kind of subject. What
but it's like race is the big, but race is the big elephant in the room.
Of course,
I mean it's everybody's talking about race.
Well, let me.
It's like, but nobody's allowed to talk about the largest study on diversity. Okay, scientifically, it's called the Robert Putnam study. It's from Harvard.
Mm-hmm.
It had 32,000 people in it, and the study showed that diversity is not a strength. That diversity divides communities.
Okay.
For example, look at any major city in America. It's not diverse. Like, blacks live on one side of town, Latinos on another, and all the white people moved away.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, isn't that the truth?
Okay, let me, I love that you...
They're not really diverse.
All
like,
right. I love
like, we don't really live around each other.
Okay, let me talk about that, and I love that you brought that subject up now, because I like to speak on, when it comes to race, when somebody like yourself come and bring up a topic like that, I love it. Let me first say one thing. That study probably says that, but here's what I want to say in response to that, right? The difference between humans and animals is that we don't have to stay static, or we don't have to live within the construct of what was or what has been. We can actually make a change to make things better. That a study comes out and says that diversity is...
Yeah, but...
Let me finish. Let me finish. I need to talk, sir.
But
that, let me finish. I want to give you a chance to talk. That a study comes out and says that diversity is not a strength. So what if diversity is not a strength? Because we are human beings, and because we are a diverse society, right? A society that has a whole lot of different kind of people in it. And because having things separate in that manner is not only inefficient, but it is scientifically stupid. And when I say scientifically stupid, is that when you divide by pigmentation, which is what we've learned from white supremacy, dividing by pigmentation is sort of a stupid thing, because pigmentation has so little to do with humanity that we play right into let me finish. We play right into that which these people started. Go ahead.
Yeah, the real reason that racism exists and diversity doesn't work is because it goes way more than just pigmentation.
Oh.
There's huge differences in crime levels.
Oh.
There's huge differences in test scores.
Yes.
For example, black Americans get the lowest grades in America, and you want to act like all races are exactly the same? Are you serious?
Okay, now that you said that, I love that you said that as well, my friend. You're absolutely right that if you take a look scholastically right now, that in this country, in America, black people have the lowest test scores. But let me go and tell you something that you don't know. And what happened is the ignorance of the vast majority of Americans, because they're so not exposed to the rest of the world, is the following. If I go to Jamaica, if I go to Panama...
White people don't want to be exposed to the rest of the world. We want to quit being invaded.
You know what? Are you going to make me... You know, I love
people,
you so...
People,
hey, brother, I love you so much. I'm going to extend the show because I love this subject. All our listeners, the show has just changed topic to race, and this is going to be the end of the teacher show, given that it's 3:15, it's 4 o'clock now, and I'm going to have an extended show with, what is your name again, sir?
Mike.
Mike. We're going to have a new show started here. Yeah,
yep.
We're going to have a new show starting here with Mike before I end, because Mike brought up a subject that a lot of people are looking at that I think is so very important. Okay, Mike, here's the deal. I'd like you to make your comment about the difference in races and academics and scholastic aptitude. Why don't you go, and then I'll answer you again.
Okay, anybody who ever has the guts to Google average IQ among race groups, which you probably have never done, by the way,
mm-hmm.
is well aware that there's a big difference in average intelligence among race groups,
mm-hmm.
and it has nothing to do with education. As a matter of fact, most scientists, they now think that IQ is over 80% genetic. So when blacks complain about how they never get good schools, even though they live in the USA, which has the best schools in the world, especially compared to a third world country like Africa, it's ridiculous.
Okay.
You blame all black failure on other people. Go ahead.
All right. Thank you so kindly for saying that, because you're so wrong. First of all, American blacks.
Yeah, right.
American blacks, there's a history that have created this problem. When it comes to IQ, who determines what goes into an IQ test? If you're in a country where you drink from a saucer and a cup, then that person will know everything about saucers and cup. If you're from a culture that doesn't have those particular issues, an IQ test means nothing. So an IQ test is only valid when you're talking about things that are absolute math. But let's go further than that. When you look at, if you go ahead and you were to go tonight, if you were to talk about people in Nigeria,
okay.
Or people, I'm not done. If you were to
talk,
no, you can't. If you talk about people in Nigeria or people elsewhere where there is a monolith of black people, right? And you go ahead and do the gradation of IQs, you'll get a shocking surprise. Because if you take a look at the societal norms here in the United States, the most successful group in this country is Nigerians, okay? The most educated folks and intelligent folks in this country are Nigerians. And the funny thing about it is you have never heard that. And never heard that? Let me tell you why I've never heard
that. Yes, I have.
Let me finish.
Yes, I've heard that.
Hold on.
I've heard that before.
Michael, hold a second now. Let me tell you what happens here. There's nothing genetic about intelligence. It makes a white supremacy a thing. It makes you feel good. It makes you feel like there's something you have, others don't. But here's a real issue that you need to look into, right? Instead of wasting time on it, because I can guarantee you...
No, you're talking too long.
Hold on.
You're talking forever.
Michael,
you need to let me talk.
Michael, hold on.
You're talking forever, dude.
Michael, it's my show. Michael, here's the deal. Here's the funny thing about it, Michael. I am a black man, a proud black man, and I can guarantee you one thing. We can go ahead and do any kind of test, both you and I. And I can guarantee you, there's nothing in that test that you're going to be able to supersede me on. And you know what? I don't think I'm more intelligent than you are. Let me tell you what I think the differences are between you and me. The difference between me and you is I chose to be educated. You chose to be deceived. Continue. You notice what happens to people when they are no longer able to talk or able to defend their position? They leave. Folks, this is Politics Done Right. Before I go, however, I'd like to remind you that this is a show. This is a progressive show. And what we try to do is give you fact-based information. And what we try to counter are people like Michael as well. We love Michael. Michael is sick. Michael is ill. Michael needs to feel that somehow he's better than somebody else. He's not. But as long as he can hold on to that, he doesn't have to do the hard work to make himself better. For that, I don't hate him. For that, I don't dislike him. I do feel sorry for him because he's not a very intelligent person. He chose not to be a very intelligent person. He could be, but he chose not to be.